Good morning. Welcome to Sewing 101. The first lesson is getting to know your sewing machine. We will learn the names of the sewing machine parts and their function. So now, let's begin. First, we're going to begin with a buttonhole fine adjusting screw. Turn the buttonhole fine adjusting screw to adjust buttonhole stitching when it is not uniform. Next, we have the pattern selection dial. This is the pattern selection dial, and this is used to select the number of the stitch that you want to use. Next, we have the thread take-up lever. This is the thread take-up lever, which is controlled by the hand wheel. And next, we have the upper tension control dial. This controls the tension on the upper thread. Next, we have the flatbed attachment accessory storage. And this is where you can store additional items like sewing machines, the extra bobbin and thread. Next, we have the reverse sewing lever. This is the reverse sewing lever. Press and hold down the reverse sewing lever to sew in the opposite direction. Next, we're going to the built-in handle. This is where the built-in handle is located, and you can carry your sewing machine. Next, we have the spool pin. This is the spool pin, and the spool pin holds the spool of thread into place. And this is the bobbin winder. The bobbin winder winds thread onto the bobbin for use as the lower thread. Next is the hand wheel. Use the hand wheel to manually raise and lower the needle. Next, we have the main power and sewing light. This is used to control the power and light on the sewing machine. And this is the presser foot jack. This is where you plug the foot controller into and supplies power to the machine. Next, we have the presser foot lever. This is the presser foot lever. Use the presser foot lever to raise and lower the presser foot. Next, we have the bobbing winding pretension disc, the thread guide. The thread guide bobbin winding pretension disc is used when winding the thread onto the bobbin and threading the machine. And lastly, we have the foot controller. This is normally placed on the floor and it's used to control the sewing speed and to start and stop sewing. I would like to thank you for attending Sewing 101. Thanks.